When you want to make a shortwave radio in a completely classical way, old school way with a local oscillator, etc., etc., you need an oscillator that works in the band where you want to receive your radio stations. So when you want to receive radio stations around 7 MHz, the oscillator also has to operate approximately on 7 MHz. And that's what we call to get the radio in the band. The right frequency band, that's what's meant. Of course, we have to do with the IF frequency, this is an IF transformer, and it means that when you receive a certain frequency band on shortwave, the oscillator, the local oscillator, must oscillate 455 kHz up to that frequency or 455 kHz down to that frequency. This has to do with two things, upmixing or downmixing, but the whole issue is not very complicated. It only means that you have a circuit in which the frequency on the antenna coil is transformed into the low frequency from 455 kHz. This is a local oscillator, and now I want to pay some attention to the question how to get such an oscillator in a band. For instance, when you want to receive radio stations on 2.5 MHz, the local oscillator here also must oscillate on approximately 2.5 MHz. When you want to receive radio stations in the 7 MHz band, the local oscillator has also to oscillate approximately in the 7 MHz band. Because the frequency difference between the EF frequency and the received frequency is not so high. I made here a completely experimental circuit. This is the tuning capacitor from an old Sony radio connected to this coil. So here we have this tank circuit, and this tank circuit is related to a certain frequency. At the moment, this tank circuit oscillates on 3.9 MHz. According to the radio theory, when you want to go to a higher frequency, you need less windings on the coil. So when you shortcut the coil here, I mean apart from the coil, not the complete coil of course, because then the oscillator doesn't work. Apart from the coil, and I've done that here, we go to a higher frequency. But one of the problems is, for instance, when you make such an oscillator, when you shortcut too much from that coil, I've made a few taps, the oscillation completely stops. Sometimes when we raise the voltage to the oscillator, the oscillation starts again, but of course that's quite difficult because your whole radio must operate, for instance, on 12 volts. So I remove the shortcut wire from the coil again, and we have here again a beautiful oscillation at 12 volts approximately on 3.9 megahertz. I tune the tuning capacitor. We see the frequency change from high to low, 2.9, 3.9, and That means that when I want to go to a higher frequency band, I have to make another coil. So this coil is not adequate to reach, for instance, a frequency band from 7 MHz or so, where many broadcasting radio stations are active. And that shows the problem from such a simple oscillator circuit, VFO circuit. You have to do experiments with the tuning capacitor here and the coil, the form of the coil, for instance, how the coil was made. And a good advice is to make, for instance, the diameter from the coil bigger to get to a higher frequency band and use thicker wire. Isolate it with plastic. That's the best wire to use in such a circuit because it gives a natural spacing between the windings. So when I want to go to higher frequencies here, I have to use another form, say from approximately 2 cm in diameter, and use somewhat thicker wire or the same wire to get the oscillator to oscillate, so that it does not stop when you are tuning to the radio stations, for instance on a higher frequency, say 7 MHz or so. Also important, the potentiometer from 20 to K, it sets the whole circuit to oscillate. And you can also do experiments with the emitter resistor. Lower it or make it somewhat higher to get a pure waveform. I think the circuit here is more or less ideal or quite good. It works surely up to approximately 12 MHz. I want to make a final demonstration. When I put in here, for instance, a ferrite rod, the frequency goes down very substantially. You can see that here. And also you can see that on the counter, 1.2 MHz. And when I tune the capacitor now, here, this capacitor, you can also see that the frequency goes substantially down to 1 MHz. And when I tune the capacitor out to a lower capacitance, it's 1.3 MHz. So we are in a medium wave band. This is absolutely medium wave band, where you can receive many radio stations with this local oscillator. And here you can see that too, how the frequency changes. Very substantial changing in frequency. And when I take the core out, I will do that now, the frequency goes up to a high value, 3.9 MHz. So these are all tricks and applications, advices to bring a certain local oscillator in the band where you want to receive radio stations or where you want to make your circuit work. This has not only to do with radio. You can also use this circuit for other applications. Always the circuit must be tuned into the frequency band where you want the circuit to work. And this is the way to do that.